Hey guys, I'm Tyson and this is Callie. We're with Agaviation Adventures. Welcome to the Crop Duster Classroom. Now we have Callie assisting us with the whiteboard today. People have said, I want to see more of Callie. Well, here she is doing an amazing job holding this board. Also, she cut out and applied this really nice vinyl sticker that represents a field for us. So we're talking about winds. Something that I get asked about from agronomists is, hey, why aren't you spraying? It seems like a perfect day to spray. There's a bunch of herbicide to do, meaning that what I'm spraying is gonna probably kill a lot of other stuff around the crop that I'm spraying. It's not gonna kill the crop I'm spraying, but there's other stuff right next to it that it probably will kill. So why am I not spraying? It's like a 1 mile an hour wind. There's no wind, it's 2 miles an hour. Well, I'm gonna tell you. The problem with spraying in light winds or calm winds is that they are extremely variable. So let's take, for example, our nice green field here. We're gonna say that it's edible beans. And this is actually something that I was just doing today. So that's why we're talking about it. We've got our edible bean field. And over here in red, we have we've got an 80 of sugar beets, and then up to the top we have another quarter of sugar beets. And once you see my fields, you're going to know why hers was so much better. So we've got sugar beets here and sugar beets here, and then the rest of this stuff is there's another field here, and it's fine. It is wheat that's already been harvested. And this one down here is gonna be soybeans, but they're already dead. And then this one is another edible bean field, and we can spray it and drift on it because it's also needing to die. So we're spraying Sharpen on it. We're actually desiccating this field so that they can harvest it. Problem is, what we're spraying on this edible bean field will kill these beets and it'll kill these beets. If we go out there with a really light wind, let's say it's 1 mile an hour, which this kind of happened a little bit earlier today. Let's just say it's a 1 mile an hour wind coming out of the southwest like that. We're like, well, this is great because it's going to blow away from these beets right here. However, it's still going to get into these beets, so you'd want to leave a bunch off so you don't kill them. The problem with having this 1 mile an hour wind is it's never actually just a consistent 1 mile an hour. Maybe it'll be one, and then maybe it'll be zero, and then maybe it'll jump up to three. And what you get with that is if I was out in this field right here and I go down the edge like this, and I smoke the field, which if you haven't seen the smoker video, check that out. You'll kind of know what I'm talking about here. If I smoke the edge of this field, what happens is that my smoke may move this way away from the field. And then I've got some smoke right here, and this one may just kind of move up like that. And then I smoke it again right here, and this one kind of moves actually this direction a little bit because it's zero now, and so it just kind of moves wherever it wants to go. So if I'm actually spraying the field like that, my spray may move away, and then it may move back to it, and then it may move away, and then it just kind of does whatever it wants. It wants to just sit out there and float, and I cannot work up against any susceptible crops that are around this field, because if I get right next to these beets, well, when that, actually not this beet field, this one because of the direction of the wind. If I get right next to this and that wind dies and it's really variable like that, it's going to drift into those beets a little bit. And we don't want that. We don't want dead beets. So that's what happens if the wind is light, but also if the wind is light, and it wasn't so much like this today, but this can happen, absolutely. We'll throw a shot into the wind gauge what it looks like when it's like this. But when the winds are generally just light, you can actually have the wind. Here's a dial, and this is the center. It's 360 degrees around this dial. And what happens when the light winds are light and variable is that sometimes they're out of this direction, and then literally 10 seconds later, they're out of this direction, and then maybe they come over here and they're out of this direction, and then 50 seconds later, they're out of this direction. And then they come over here and a minute later, they're out of this direction, and they're literally working their way around 360 degrees. So if you're out spraying this field and you're spraying it with herbicide, these are light winds. This is not doing it when it's blowing at 10 miles an hour like this. That's not going to happen. But when it's light, it'll absolutely just sit there and work itself around a 360 degree circle all day long. So if you're trying to work up against the edge of this field, your spray can do something like that and it'll drift all over the place. If you guys have any questions about it, definitely leave them in the comments section below and we'll get back to you. Let's thank Callie for doing an amazing job holding this whiteboard, because I wouldn't be able to hold it and talk. I can barely talk alone without having to hold this thing. So we really appreciate having her here. If you guys want to see more of her, check her out on Instagram. It's agaviationadventures. However, she runs all of it. She's behind it. She's always posting stories and photos during the spray season. So if you're ever like, man, I want to see more of these videos, well, check us out on Instagram, because you probably will be finding that we're over there quite a bit. We do appreciate you guys watching. Again, if you have questions, leave them and we'll get back to you. I'm Tyson. This is Callie. We're with Ag Aviation Adventures. Fly low and fly fast.